I happen to think that a lady is the most beautiful creature in the whole world. I think it's natural that she should want to augment this potential. I think it's natural that she should stand on high heels. And that, therefore, once you stand on high heels, all the bumps and curves of her beautiful physique come into play. This fact of standing on two legs gives you a bottom that no other animal's got. And this woman is just incredible. One of the very first things that I do when I'm doing a collection, it may sound surprising, but I actually write the running order, starting from the first outfit, so that I write a description of what she's going to be wearing. And you can't, obviously, it changes, but you start off with a provisional running order. And in fact, that's how the show builds, how your imagination works. Very often the shows end up like theatre because these clothes, right from the beginning, often have one person in mind. And then according to her personality, you sort of, you know, can emphasise the whole thing in one direction or not. If you have money to do things with, it's so much more easier than when you're cutting corners at every stage. I mean, even in a fashion show in the past, I've had like 8 pairs of shoes for the whole lot of the models, and it's been 2 or 3 people's job backstage to just run around madly giving people shoes to put on just before they're ready to go on the catwalk, and they're all waiting for the shoes. I mean, I've had shows with the models sewing backstage and all the audience really getting annoyed. I don't know, but anyway. We're used to doing these shows by now, and I think the producers know how to pace the shows and everything, so we can just really essentially enjoy it. I mean, you do run around and say, like, where's your hat or whatever to somebody. Kate Moss usually does things like that. Kate Moss, where's your hat? Oh, yeah. One of the biggest thrills is backstage, the queue of models as they're lining up to go on. They're lining up, waiting to go on, but they're also completely mad to see who's coming next. And they're all looking at each other and just, you know, cracking up or whatever they're doing, but very, very excited. It must be great for those girls to go on the catwalk.
Thank you.
It is really true to say that I play very much with the polarities of masculine and feminine, and that tailoring is the basis for that. Of course, I've always got somewhere in the show the very, very English red that you have for fox hunting. It's the, I mean, the Japanese call it that colour Vivienne red because I use it all the time.
I don't know if you've seen my shoes but that I wore, but they're like this high, like violet purple platforms, and I had rubber stockings and like a feather bow and stuff, and I was walking down at my fourth step, and I had never worn these heels before so high, so I like took a step and I completely just went down. And all I could think about is, you know, what would Vivienne do? What would she do? What would she tell me to do? So I thought she'd tell me to get up, laugh it off and get up and keep walking, which is what I did.
Thank you.
my job, more than anything, is to idealise women. And when I've got these perfect beauties to put the clothes on, it's an amazing treat for me. When I was backstage at the show, I didn't know whether these ladies were monsters or goddesses. They just looked out of this world, really beyond human. They just looked so stunning. And for me to be able to do that, can you imagine the reward of working for 6 months when you see that on somebody backstage and then later on when I get to see the video and how they behave? It is like theatre because it is like seeing your work come alive. This coat is an exact copy of a man's frock coat from the time of Louis XV. It's the kind of coat that Casanova would have worn. And I can just imagine, or barely imagine, how wonderful it would have been to have been in one of those salons with men dressed in this way, spending all this effort and charm to court ladies. You know, they had these great lace cuffs and their handkerchiefs and their snuff and their little, I don't know, little patch, black patches and their rouged cheeks. and the attention that they would have given to these ladies who couldn't have been serious with their corsets, which pushed their bosom up. So you had these little sort of moving orbs every time they breathed. I mean, how palpitatingly provocative and stimulating it must have been. I mean, I went to an evening gala thing recently with a smoking coat on, with a 6-foot trail and a train, and I was really happy to have it getting dirty and dragging over everything. I think it's really great to walk down the street with a big long train and get it filthy dirty and collect all the rubbish and cigarette packets. I'm really against all this sort of hygiene. I think it's great to mess your clothes up like that. Let me just say one thing that's more important than any of that, and that is that in terms of a silhouette, a train holds a line because it's dragging on the floor, and you can get the most brilliant things, the most brilliant effects with a train. We'll be right back. I'm not a feminist because I do find that feminism is too closely linked with a Puritan attitude. And I can't see how anyone would object to a lady at the height of her beauty without any clothes on whatsoever. But I would say that it's even better with a pair of high heel shoes.